Hello, this is Crochet Basics with Kay Jolie, and in this episode we're going to make this pattern, this owl, and we're going to revamp the pattern to make it into a bat. So, kind of fun, you know, came up with it a few days ago thanks to my sister, Crafty Conjuring, had been watching my videos when she was re-watching an owl video, and said, you know, I think that a little owl would make a great bat. So let's revamp this pattern and make it into this. So what you need for this pattern is I'm using acrylic yarn. I'm gonna use gray. I'm using Karen. I get it by the pound, of course. F hook, which is F5. A 3.75 millimeter hook, a nice small hook with the big worsted weight yarn is perfect. It makes the stitches nice and tight so you don't see the stuffing come through it. A white for the teeth if you're gonna do the teeth, you know, do the little fangs or whatever. I used googly eyes. If you wanna use buttons, that's fine. I just wanted it to be more fun and just a, you know, quick and easy embellishment, so to speak, you know. You can use a measuring tape if you like. You need a scissor. You need polyfill or some kind of stuffing. You know, polyfill works. And you also need a yarn needle. So you can use a tapestry needle or, you know, one of these plastic jammies. One of these plastic jammies is perfect. Okay, or like a tapestry needle. That'll work fine too. And so let's get this going. And you'll need one piece of yarn in a contrasting color just to mark your stitches. So I'm gonna do mine in the gray. I did it, the first one I made was in the black, but just so that you could see the stitches better, I'm gonna do it in the gray. So starting with your gray, if you do a slip knot, that's fine. I don't normally start with a slip knot. I do a crossover on my hook, and you're gonna chain two, and in that second chain from the hook you're going to do five single crochets. And you'll hold your tail to your loop so that you could just pull it tight and it'll close up that hole later on. So you'll pull that loop, it'll close up that hole, and you'll skip over your first chain and you'll go right in to the first single crochet that you made, and you'll do two single crochets in that one, and you'll do two single crochets all the way around. So hopefully you end up with 10 single crochets for the second row. So from here, what you can add your contrasting piece of yarn in to mark your spot. Now for the third row, for row three, you're going to do two single crochets in the first loop, and one in the next, and two in the one after that, and you'll repeat that for the row, and hopefully you end up with 15. So from here, I'm just gonna make a little knot in my starting tail, and then just snip it off. It's not, it, you know, if you, as long as you crochet around it, that knot will hold it to place, and you won't have any, it won't come out. I've never seen it come out on a hat or an amigurumi or any kind of thing like that. So easy peasy, right? So for row four, you'll do two single crochets in the first, one single crochet in the next two, and then two in the next after that, and just repeat that all the way around. Now for row five, you'll do two single crochets in the first and one single crochet in the next three stitches and then two in the one after that, so you'll just repeat that all the way around. Okay, so now from here, for the next, from row 6 to row 15, for the next 10 rows, you're going to do one single crochet all the way around, and you'll follow your stitch marker up. So what you can do, just to keep your place so that you know that this is where you stopped increasing, so that you only have to count back 10 rows, is take the contrasting yarn, stick it to the back, and just crochet right over it, and later on when we're done we'll pull it right out and not a big deal. So it's just gonna hold our place and we'll know from here up we didn't increase. So from row 6 to row 15, no increase. One single crochet all the way around. So this is 15 rows in. Okay, so at this point I'm gonna put in teeth. So you'll measure it from your 15th row and then three down, you know, so one, two, three, and then over here in between, what is this, the 12th and 13th row. Okay, so I don't know, I guess the white will show, I'm not sure if it'll show because I did the first one in black, but this one I'm doing in gray. And that's if you're gonna do the teeth, you know, the little fangs or whatever. So you'll turn this side seam, if you've seen, you know, my previous tutorials or whatever. You know, I make that a side seam, so that it's inconspicuous. Not that it's gonna really show on this because it's all one color, but that's okay. So you just wanna make a little triangle with the white. Then you'll go over a few and you'll make another triangle. Trying to make sure you don't hit your working yarn, you know, because we still have a few more rows to do. Not bad. The other one came out better, I think. I think I'm a little rushed on this one because this is the second time I made the video. This time around, my computer memory card got accidentally erased right after I finished videoing this like 2 days ago. So from here we'll do, and you can always do felt, you know, the pieces of felt, you could do felt teeth. This is just what I have out. So for the next five rows, from row 16 to row 20, you'll do one single crochet and you'll pull a tail for sewing because we're gonna seam up the top and then we'll make the wings. So for the next five rows, up to row 20, one single crochet in each stitch. Alright, so that's row 20. I'm gonna pull a tail for sewing and I'm gonna get my stuffing out to stuff this baby and get her sewn up. Get it sewn up on the top. So that's our stitch marker. We don't really need that anymore. And let's get our yarn needle. Now I use a polyfill, which is the lighter one. It's light and fluffy. I like it. I think it has like a lot of bounce back, you know, it holds its shape. I always feel that it's light, you know, it's lightweight, but it holds its shape a bit better. Sometimes the heavier one, I feel like it, you know, it like condenses, like the air comes out of it and then it just becomes like a rock, to, you know, my opinion, you know. So, but whichever you prefer. So you want to get your stuffing all the way down to the bottom. Stuff this baby up. Now you don't have to get all your stuffing in now because you'll have a minute to do that after we start sewing her up. You don't want to overstuff. You don't want to space out your stitches. I'm sorry, I'm so serious today, but I think I'm just, you know, I filmed this whole thing and then my computer unplugged and my memory card blanked and so now I'm trying to do this and I don't really have too much time to do it, to get this up there and all that kind of thing. All right, so from here, you don't need this much of a tail, I'm just a stickler. So from here, you're gonna squeeze it shut. Make sure your teeth, your little teeth are centered on the front. And what you're going to do is you're going to sew around, not back and forth. So you'll go in, make sure you catch every one of your stitches, okay? At least twice, you know, make sure it's sealed up nice and good. So, but what you're gonna do is you're gonna push it down and you'll go in through the back, come out through the front. So we'll make the seam itself seem invisible. And you'll sew it, you know, to the middle. So from here, what you're gonna do is you're gonna push your needle underneath your stitches and come out through the side. Okay, and you're gonna pinch this down, make it a little triangle. And you're just gonna go around a few times out from this, in from the side to over the seam and back through, and squeeze it, you know, pinch it down and squeeze it tight to make that nice triangle. Not bad. And then you'll go back in under your stitches and push it through to where. Try not to stab yourself. And then you'll continue sewing. And at this point, if you need to add more stuffing, do it, because now we're gonna finish sealing up this little bat, okay? So as much stuffing as you can get in without overstuffing it. You don't want to stretch out your stitches, you know, you don't want to see the stuffing coming through. I think it ruins the illusion that it's alive. No, I'm kidding, but but it's true. You know, you don't want to see the stuffing coming through. You know, because if it wasn't crocheted or knit, you know, a regular teddy bear that's fabric or material, you're not gonna see that stuffing, you know, it's a solid piece. And that's really what you want to achieve here, I think. I mean, well, you know, my opinion, I guess. But that's what I would assume you would want to achieve, you know, a nice, sturdy, solid piece. You know, as far as your, you know, your amigurumis are concerned. So from here, I'm gonna do the same thing I did on the other side. I'm gonna follow right here. Okay. Pinch it down, go across, and go around your stitches, you know. So not bad. I mean, either way, you're gonna have to adjust, because sewing it together, and then also, you know, when we put the wings on, you're gonna have to adjust again anyway. So don't worry about that too much. That's our piece so far. Okay. So now let's make our wings. Okay. So for the wings, same size hook, F hook. and you're going to chain 16, and you'll leave a tail for sewing, going on. Okay, so chain 16. So from here, you're going to slip stitch the first three. So you'll skip the first one from the hook, and then you'll just slip stitch. So here's one, two, three, and then you'll do 12 half double crochets for the rest of the row. So you'll chain one and turn your work, and then you'll do 10 single crochets. You'll do one single crochet in the first 10 stitches going back. So from here, you're going to chain three. So one, two, three. You'll turn your work and you'll skip that first one and you'll slip stitch back four slip stitches back. So one, two, three, four, and do 8 half double crochets. Chain one, turn your work. So you do 6 single crochets for this row. 2, 3. All right, so then we're gonna chain 3. 1, 2, 3. Turn your work, you'll skip the first one closest to the chain, of course, and then you'll slip stitch 4 again, going back. Do 1 single crochet. Chain 3, 1, 2, 3, skip that first one, and then slip stitch the 5 remaining stitches you got here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, which is your last one. Okay, so pull a tail. So that's what our first wing looks like, and going to do here is get your needle and thread the bottom one. Okay, the one you just pulled off, thread that one onto your needle. From here, you're going to feed the needle up. So you'll go in and out, and you're going to, cinch it. You're going to cinch it, is the word. Okay. So you'll cinch it nice and tight. Okay, you cinch the wing. You can make a knot if you like. If not, you don't have to. okay? And from here, I'm going to use both tails to sew it to my guy here. I must say, this is weird. I feel so serious. I don't know why. Okay, so you'll put it right around where his teeth are, if you could see. Right below where his teeth are. So right here. Okay. And you'll just go through a few times. You know, through the body, through the wing. I'm sorry, I keep banging into the camera. And if you sew it a little bit on an angle, you know, make sure you catch the top, it'll go up like that. Okay? So just a few times around if you're sewing it, you know, it should be fine. Okay? So you do the same thing with the next swing after you pull your tail. I don't know why I cut so much tail. I'm so silly. You do not need that much tail at all. So. You put that on a yarn needle. So there you have it, my owl to bat pattern. So if you make it, let me know, you know, comment, like, subscribe, all that good stuff, you know. So, cute, right? And if you're going to string it up, just, you know, go through the wings, a little clear, Have a good one. Bye.